My grandmother used to say, if you want to make God laugh, tell him your plans.
You guys play a lot, huh? What do you play?
In the street.
In the street? What about the cars?
We have to move every time. It stinks.
Okay. You were here, you were here, and you're here. What's your name?
David.
Huh?
David.
Are you ready, David? Where's the ball? You guys are sleeping, huh? Francisco! My name looks pretty lonely on this ball.
How about I get a few more names on here for you? Like Tomás Córdoba.
El Puma?
Francisco, por favor, brother, ya, ¿no? No, qué barbaridad. Ya ni tu hermanita, ¿eh?
Roma no se construye en un día, ¿eh? Esto toma tiempo. Anda, vámonos de acá.
All right, guys. I'll bring this one back to you. I promise.
Later.
Okay.
See ya.
All right.
What are we gonna play with until you get back?
Yasmin, could you get one of those practice balls Francisco keeps in his closet?
No.
Esas bolas son carísimas. Tranquilo, hermano, no se preocupe. Se acabó la pobreza, ¿eh?
Tienes razón. Arra. Call me if you need a manager,
eh?
Thanks. Vámonos de acá.
Yeah! All right. I'm ready.
Soccer player, man. I hate interviews. I told you. I'm not a speaker.
Pero bueno, ¿te acordás de lo que te enseñé, no?
Sí.
Practica conmigo, ¿eh?
¿Es en español o en inglés?
¿Qué sé yo? ¿En inglés? Yo no sé. Practica conmigo. Anda.
I'm happy to the opportunity and to be here with all of you.
Te voy a hacer una pregunta. ¿Dónde aprendiste inglés vos? ¿Nunca saliste de Miami? Che, tenés que hacerlo con clase, boludo. Quizás una lagrimita, un poco de emoción. I am thrilled to be here in this outstanding presence of you beautiful people. ¿Dónde te pones? Si acaso, te pones la gorrita. I am ecstatic to be here in front of all you beautiful people today. I want to thank my wonderful manager Francisco, etc., etc., Club Madrid, etc. Un poco de emoción. ¿Entendés lo que te digo? Así que se hace.
Tú deberías hacer la entrevista.
Definitivamente, ¿cómo me veo, eh?
Ay, perruchón, ¿eh? Hecho a mano, papá.
¿Serio?
Esa gorrita representa 2 milloncitos.
2.2. Acá no se redondea, ¿vale? Che, mañana vas a estar en todas las revistas, desde Canadá hasta la Argentina. De mañana te veo hasta en la sopa. Espectacular.
Morning, Manny.
Morning. Henry, have more than enough fresh mint at the bar.
You bet. And don't worry, I have the mojitos down.
You better. That's our signature drink. And if they ask, say you're Irish, Cuban, not Mexican, Cuban, the whole place is something Cuban for the week. Try his new drink, see how good it is. Excuse me. That's a good sauce. Buenas, Amelia.
Buenos dias, señor.
Nice. Very nice.
Anybody seen Nina?
I can't believe this. I think I left my wallet at home. Can I come back and pay you later? I live close by.
What's up with Nina? She was late yesterday, and today she's 20 minutes late. That's 2 days in a row. Plus pulling in sick last week at the last minute makes 3. And you know what happens to 3, Jose.
She'll be here.
Can't run my business like this. I just can't.
Jose, try this.
Chile un poquito más de pasote. Oye, hey, Pepito, ven acá. Just a little bit. What's for family dinner? It's almost ready, yes?
Yeah. Chiles rellenos, roasted quail, and mole rojo.
What? That's a pretty fancy family dinner.
The chiles are going bad, man.
I'm talking about the quail, Jose. It could have been a special. Oh, I see how it works, huh? You just make the fancy staff orders and I pay for them, right? Wrong. We cook for the customers, not the staff. Next time you feed them tacos con arroz y ya.
And what color is it?
Pink.
No.
Green.
What do butterflies do?
Fly!
Yay! Ready to the cloud. Let's go. Wow. Okay, Luch, you ready to play again?
Yes.
Okay. Look out.
You ready, right? Let's go, Marco, andale, andale, jefe. Today's special is pescado siete mares. Shrimp and crab legs over Mexican sweet black rice squash with a papaya lemon oil. There are 3 boxes of shrimp in the walk-in, people, so push it, push it, push it. By the end of the day, this item should be 86 in my kitchen. The last special is scallops. I think you've all served this before, so I'm not gonna say anything else about it. I got a special treat, Pepito. This coming Friday, the national Mexican soccer team, along with the coach, will be here for the Gold Cup. They play the U.S. out in Jersey next week. I'm putting them in Kevin's section. There will be no autographs. I will ask them personally, and then you can ask me. Francisco made the reservations. He asked for you.
Manny, I'm sorry.
I don't want to hear it.
Look, I have been...
Things? You see Amelia? 3 kids and comes down here from the Bronx every day. You wanna know how many days she's been late in the last 4 years? Zero, Nina. Zero.
I know. I know how
you
hard
know.
That must
you
be.
Know. Okay. So you know. So you know how easy it'll be for you when your kids are old to find another job.
Manny, please, give me another chance. I promise I'll make everything good. How could you be so...
So what? Unfair? It will be unfair if, in fact, you went late. It will be unfair to your coworkers for me to let them continue doing your job. This is the second day in a row, Nina. Not counting the times people look the other way or cover for you.
What are you talking about?
You called in sick twice last week. Then you show up to work hungover.
No, I was not hungover.
It's too much already.
Manny, I was not hungover. I was sick.
You're directing traffic for the construction site? Stay out of this.
Nina! It's unconscious, but I think he'll survive.
Thank you. Guess I'll see you around.
Hey, why were you late? You know my brother.
Oh, trust me, I know your brother. He's a jerk.
Excuse me, you going in?
Didn't have to humiliate me like that in front of everyone. I've been working for him for 4 years. And you tell him that I wasn't hungover, I was really sick. I'm pregnant. Yeah. This is one of the first mornings I haven't thrown up. Okay, I've had enough for today. Thank you. You better get back to your boss man.
Wait, wait, Nina. So what now?
Guess I'm gonna have to figure that out, right?
You wanna talk about it?
Manny, Jose left.
What do you mean left?
Who's gonna run the line?
Jose is gonna run the line.
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, sorry for the interruption. We are the Dramatics, and we would like to entertain you. After our presentation, donations will be gladly accepted.
My brother.
You don't have your phone? Here.
Pepito, chop these.
Callejón.
How may I help you?
Manny?
Where are you?
I'm with Nina.
Who the heck is Nina?
I'm your brother.
I know, man. I know.
Sorry, you owe me a five. I gave you a 10, that's 350.
I need to help Nina right now.
You need to do what? You need to be here. You work at a restaurant, not a counseling clinic.
You give me five. I give you 350. What a 150.
Now you better get back here before I
can't. I can't.
What? What do you mean you can't?
Just look in your till, man. You'll see that I gave you a 10.
Listen to me, idiota. If you're not here in the next 10 minutes, you better be at an employment office.
Manny?
Hello?
Police? Go ahead, Korea. Call him. Call him for stealing my money.
Not from Korea. I'm from China.
You go now. Alejandro! Alejandro! Llama a la policía. Rápido!
Day, sir. Oh man, that was crazy.
What happened?
What happened? It sounded like that Chinese guy was speaking Spanish. Just a typical New York moment. I need to have to leave.
Why would you leave?
It takes money to live here. Right about now, they're seeing the winter's party in my section. They're usually good for a $200 tab.
You'll be fine. Don't worry. I mean, there's plenty of restaurants in this city.
It's not that. just looking for a job. It sucks. The applications, the questioning. I'm gonna need references. What do you think Manny's gonna say about me?
List me as a reference.
Who knows? You're probably gonna be pounding the pavement right along with me.
Hey, today is my first time. It takes three times.
Yeah, but you're the chef. And you walked out.
Are you hungry?
Yeah. You could eat.
I know a good place.
I don't know what I'm gonna do with this dress. Probably put it on eBay.
Can I interest you in one of my creations, young lady? How about this nice bra?
I'm sorry, I don't have any cash on me.
Okay. Today is a beautiful day, right?
I guess.
Describe it to me.
What?
Describe it to me. And this piece of art is yours.
Okay. There's some yellow flowers blooming on it.
For Cynthia.
Yeah. And some purple ones, too.
I see.
You really like flowers, huh?
Oh, yeah. What's going on across the street?
It's just an ordinary day in New York City, you know? People rushing back and forth, cars driving, everybody's got somewhere to go, somewhere to be. Nobody really cares about nothing. It's like a huge living clock. Never stops.
Oh, I wish I could see that. Thank you. And you. You keep it real. I got my eye on you.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Look at this stuff. I love stuff like this. Do you have a mirror? Thank you. How do you do?
Looks pretty good, huh?
Sure. Jose? Oh my gosh, it is you.
Helen.
Look at you. How have you been? I haven't seen you in so long.
Fine. I mean...
Oh, I'm sorry. I heard about what happened to you.
This is Nina. Nina, this is Helen.
Nice dress. You must love Mexico, right? It's my work uniform. Where do you work?
We work for my brother.
Manny?
Mm-hmm. I cook at his restaurant.
And what happened to Club Madrid?
Plans change.
So you never played again? Who is she?
Someone that I used to see.
Someone you used to see, hmm? Do you think I'm as pretty as her? Of course not, she's prettier. So, someone you used to see. Boy, you are full of surprises. Can't even keep a phone well fed. You know I had to get a co-signer for this thing? That's how screwed up my credit is. Rent's due. After rent is down to my last 500, I could be picking up that big tip right now. Where is this place? Let's just eat around here.
Gracious.
Take applications on Tuesdays from 3 p.m. to 5 p.m.
Could you please tell Franny that Jose Subirán is here?
Regarding?
Just tell her that I need to borrow a pound of saffron.
What are you looking at?
I can't believe it, Jose. What a surprise, huh?
How are you doing, Franny?
It's always good to see the man with the mysterious beard. Don't tell me you really came 30 blocks for saffron.
We came here to eat. This is my friend Nina.
Oh, just taking the day off then. Nice dress. Let me guess, it was Manny's idea. It must have cost him a fortune.
He made us pay for them.
Well, I would too.
You like paella?
Yeah.
All right, we'll have you mejillones and paella for two. Paella is full of the things that you need for a child.
Who said I was having a child?
You did.
Oh, I said I was pregnant. I'm not ready to have a kid. You have a kid, your freedom's gone.
Things change.
Having a kid isn't just a change. I don't think I even like children. I just can't do it. I'm broke. And alone.
Alone?
I made my decision, okay?
What does the father think?
He's not a father, and he's not going to be a father, just like I'm not going to be a mother. Not now. Nina, Sharon? He's all for getting it taken care of. Those are the words he used, as if it were a wisdom tooth to be pulled out. You know, I wonder why kids are always the problem of the mother. Guys aren't inconvenienced by them, doesn't ruin their freedom, and yet they have all this advice. What's best for me? Getting it taken care of is what's best for me. Put yourself in my shoes. With a kid? Forget it. I invite someone up for a nightcap and pay off the babysitter. Mr. Wright's gonna say, oh yeah, I love taking care of other people's children. It's hard enough to get people's sincerity without throwing kids in the mix.
What's wrong with that plate?
They send it back.
What do you mean they send it back?
It's cold.
It's cold phone. Somebody better get the phone. I better not hear one to ring, people. Somebody better get the phone.
It's in the house, okay? That's table 2.
I'm waiting for the special. Where's the snapper? Here, take this out. Take this out for table 10. Table 10. Now, that looks like, what is that, man? What is that? Take that back.
That's on your plate.
It's for the winters.
Take it.
Matt,
do another one.
Tell Mr. Winters I love his shoes, okay? Don't give me that look, okay?
I like what you're doing to this place, huh?
Oh, you like it?
Kitchen's yours. When do you start?
How about a package deal?
Looking? I know this guy will never come down, but if you're looking, we could use someone. If he recommends you.
I recommend her.
Ring me on Monday. Okay, I'm gonna let you guys eat.
Thank you. I'll call you.
Okay.
It's nice to meet you.
It's nice to meet you too, darling.
Franny, gracias.
De nada.
Sí. That was easy. Lemon? To go to the beach with me? I want to show you something.
Okay. But I want to get out of these crazy clothes.
We can go like this.
Why not?
But first, I have to go back to the restaurant to get my wallet.
Pacing yourself there, Kevin?
Well, these were the only dishes at my station.
Okay.
Did you have a good day off? Hey, Manny. Brother's back.
Hey, El Callao, where you been, man?
Oh, man. It's been crazy. We did the best we could.
Two tables walked out on us.
You just sneaking in and out? You weren't gonna say hello?
I just came to pick up my phone, Manny.
Yes. You forgot your phone. I called you. Mama called you, sir. I found the time to call you, even though we were short one chef during our lunch rush hours. Where were you, Jose, huh? Went outside. Carlos took the trash outside. He didn't see you outside. How far outside did you go, Emmanuel? Acapulco? Where were you? We were worried. We were busy, and you bailed out on us. You abandoned your own flesh and blood. Here. You can make this up to me by cleaning up this mess. You're lucky I don't cut the whole stuff and let you do it by yourself.
Manny. I have to do this now, man.
What?
I have to go.
What? What's everybody staring at? We have work to do! You in my office right now! I called everyone. I called my mom, papa. You left all of us when you walked out of that door with your new friend. Two tables walked out on us today, Jose. Two. That's never happened before. Never. This is bad business, Jose. Bad business.
Everything to you is business. I'm sure everyone picked up the slack and got you and your restaurant through the day.
But what are you doing for them? Wait. Am I hearing this correctly? Ask Amelia. She's been here the whole time. She has four kids and commutes from the Bronx every day.
She has three kids, Manny.
She has kids!
See? You don't even know her. And you're giving the Amelia speech to me?
You're just leaving for some late drunk waitress? When did this happen?
You fired a pregnant woman, Manny.
I don't know why she was late. All I know, she was late all the time.
You ever stop to ask, huh? I mean, you know anything about any of these people besides Amelia? You know anything more than the fact that Henry, bartender, is making twice as much as Pepito, my cook?
Shh!
does Kevin always get better sections than Margarita?
Enough. Entra. Employees? What's wrong with me? What's wrong with you, man? ¿Qué te pasa, brother? Eh? ¿Qué te pasa? Carlos, Carlos, one of your people. He's below minimum wage, man. What is that? Huh? Oh, he doesn't have papers. And you can get away with it? Todos en la cocina nos partimos la madre por ti, brother. It's all about you, man.
Jose.
This pot is the same one you bought 4 years ago when you opened. It's scorched because it's old. Buy another one.
You can clean out your locker too. I'm done. And call Mama. She's worried.
Take a bath with my parents. They may have Tito Puente. I don't know about Marvin Gaye.
I thought we were going to the beach.
I live on the beach. Don't worry.
Oh, I don't worry. I used to worry. Then I did a little research, and I found out that 10 out of 10 people die. Do you think that this is all there is? That we only live once?
Well, so far, I haven't met anyone who's lived twice. Can I ask you a question?
No. I'm just kidding. What?
Nothing.
Just ask.
Have you thought about adoption?
Do we have to talk about this right now?
No.
I can't carry a living thing inside my body for 9 months and then what? Leave it on a doorstep in a basket for some stranger? To me, that's worse than anything.
It doesn't have to be a stranger.
A
So then I just start calling up relatives? My relative? Hey, Mom, I haven't talked to you in 4 years, but I got something for you. Or how about this? You can have it. I bet Manny can teach it a thing or two. The Sudan boys can raise little Nina, because right now you're probably the only person in the world I trust.
Papá.
Oye, José, ¿por dónde andas, hombre? Tu hermano se ha pasado llamando aquí todo el santo día. Me dijo que te fuiste al restaurante. ¿Qué es lo que...? ¿Qué está pasando, hijo?
Después te cuento, ¿no?
¿Está todo bien?
Usted no se preocupe, viejo, ¿ok? Tranquilo. ¿Te acuerdas de Nina?
Por supuesto que sí. Hola, mija. Esta es su casa.
It's beautiful.
A la orden.
El loco de José. ¿Quiere venir aquí? Uh-huh.
Escucha la hora y después vestida así, parece pura mexicana.
What did you say?
He said you look like a Mexican.
Oh, thank you.
Oye, ¿mi mamá está adentro?
No, se fue a shopping. Se quedan a cenar, ¿verdad?
He's inviting us for dinner.
Yo entiendo.
¿Should we stay?
Sí, gracias.
Bueno, ¿ya que insistes?
Pues seguro que insisto.
¿Y estos pinos qué?
Pues para sembrar, ¿para qué más, Barbu? No te quedes ahí parado como un palote, ayúdame. El hijo pródigo ha regresado. Qué alegría le va a dar a tu mamá, ¿eh? Cuidado por ahí, ¿eh?
This is gonna help me to plan these tricks, right?
Vas pisando hormiga. Oh, que eres más lento que una caravana de cojo. Aquí van a haber violetas, arbolito de limón, azucenas, nardos, margaritas. Bueno, en sí, eso va a ser un paraíso. ¿Sabe que a mi mujer yo la conquisté con flores? ¿A ti te gustan las flores?
What did he say?
He said that if you like flowers.
Oh. Yes, I do. I love flowers.
Sí, she likes flowers.
Ya tú ves, no hay ni una que no le gusten las flores.
Oye, papá, ¿tienes las llaves de mi coche?
¿Las llaves? ¿Y eso para qué, hijo?
Se lo quiero enseñar a Nina.
Está en mi cuarto, en el último cajón de mi escritorio. Voy a dar un bañito, me voy a cambiar de ropa.
Okay, what just happened? What?
Nothing.
Wow. Oh, man. Does it run?
Let's see.
My dad used to have an old Ford. Is it yours?
Yeah.
Well, I got the scarf. We should take a road trip across the country. Doesn't look like you drive it much.
I used to.
When was the last time you drove this thing?
Last time I drove it, I went to jail.
Car, you went to jail.
Mm-hmm.
For what?
5 years ago, I was on my way to a press conference. I had just signed a contract with the new soccer team.
Wait, you played soccer?
Mm-hmm. Everything happened so fast.
2, 1, ready or not, here I come.
To hide. Vamos arriba, ¿eh? Vamos arriba.
Lucci, I can't see you. I see you. Yeah, we're gonna play this game a lot when we go to your grandmother's. And she has horses and pigs and cows. Yeah. Oh, that's right.
Muy nervioso, ¿eh?
Ya me perdí, por
la próxima derecha.
¿A quién está?
Okay, Luch, you ready to play again? Huh?
Luch?
Yes.
Okay. Count.
¿Esos zapatos vienen con el auto?
¿Te gustan?
9, 8, 7.
Yo sé cómo ves lo que es un salvador en programa.
Papá.
Es un perro.
Where are you?
¿Qué hacemos, eh?
Vámonos de acá. ¿Qué ha sido, boludo? ¡Vámonos de acá!
Luchi, where are you? I'm coming.
¿Qué ha sido, boludo? Vení acá, escúchame, loco. Yo soy tu amigo, ¿eh? Yo soy tu manager. Te estoy diciendo, la única forma de salir de esto es andar.
Luch. Luchi.
¡Vámonos acá, José, carajo!
No puedo, man. Street, looking down at her little body.
No! No! Oh! Somebody call an ambulance! Somebody help me!
I live with it every day, Nina. I can still hear her crying and screaming for God to give her daughter back.
Why? You killed her! Why?
When I saw her mother holding, holding her dead child. I was convicted of involuntary manslaughter. My brother Manny was there all the time with me.
What about her family?
She was a single mother. They took 4 years of my life. And I took everything she had. I tried to meet with her several times, but she refused. I know all she sees in me is the one who killed her little baby.
But it was an accident.
It doesn't matter, Nina. It doesn't matter. What matters is that I took her daughter's life.
Hey, bro!
¿Qué pasó, frater?
Huh? And Nina! All right. You guys ready to meet the love of my life?
¿Esta es la de veras?
I think this is it, hermano. I'm going to marry her.
How long have you guys been together?
A week. They want you in the kitchen, hermano. All right. I promise you a bath.
It's good to see you again. Nina, right?
Right.
So the two of you took the day off?
I was kind of fired today.
Yeah, I heard. I spoke to Manny. I'm sorry. Shouldn't take it personally, though. Do you need to borrow any clothes? Because you could try some of mine.
No, thank you. Everything I need is right in here. I just have to freshen up a bit.
Huele rico, viejo. ¿Cómo está saliendo la comida?
Ah, pelado, esto está bueno. Mire, deja ese pollito. Cuando yo termine con él, vas a ver a caviar.
También, bebé. Tienes que estar perfecto, ¿ok?
Manita, ¿cómo está todo aquí, no? Me está todo bien con los manos, muy bien, ¿ok?
Ok, ok. Déjame ver.
Ok, eso está bien. Wow. Se botaron aquí con, mira, la bandera mexicana, ¿viste esto? Sigue, ok, vámonos, vámonos, vámonos.
José. ¿Me quieres explicar qué es lo que está pasando? Llamó tu hermano, quejándose porque dice que te saliste así nomás, detrás de la muchacha esta, de Nina. Luego te presentas con ella aquí como si nada. Manny está muy decepcionado de ti, hijo. Yo nunca lo había visto así. Y con razón, José. ¿Cómo se te ocurre abandonarlo? Tú eres el chef principal, hijo. Eso no se hace, y menos a un hermano.
Mamá, yo sé que la regué, pero mi intención no fue dejar a mi hermano. También Manny corrió a Nina así nada más.
¿Y qué? Eso no justifica tu actitud, José. Ahora, me dice Manuel que la muchacha viene embarazada. ¿Tú qué tienes que ver con eso? ¡Mírame cuando te hablo, carajo! Ahora llego y me dicen que estás en tu carro con Nina. ¿Qué te pasa, hijo?
Ya no te quiero ver como antes, José.
Yo sé que no puedes salvarme. I know I'm on my own. Yo sé.
Mira este qué bonito salió.
Ok, mami.
¿Ya, mi amor?
Ella está aquí. ¿Todo está listo?
Todo listo. ¿Cómo se llama?
Verónica, por favor, no te olvides. Verónica, ¿ok? Viejo, Verónica. Sí. Está José, Verónica.
Voy.
No se olvida.
Mi reina.
Siéntate ya. José, Nina. Verónica Subirán, mi novia.
Nice to meet you.
Veronica Costala. Nice to meet you. You too. Novia?
Novia means girlfriend. Futura esposa means future wife.
Eduardo es loco. He's trying to teach me Spanish.
Nina, un tequilita.
No.
Ah, no, no, no. Family Ojalá. Custom, yes.
Ojalá.
Ay, pero ay, eso no es nada. ¿Y José?
No, gracias.
Come on, hermano. ¿Mami?
¿Verónica? Es una fiesta.
Thank you.
Papi.
Oye, claro. Respeta las canas.
Ay, sí, sí, perdón. Are we going to toast? Sí.
Vamos a rezar. Should we say grace?
Wanna say grace?
Bueno, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo.
Papi, espera. Verónica and I are going to say grace. You ready? Repeat after me. El que?
El que?
Papi. This is for Verónica. Thank you. Sorry. El que?
El que?
Nos dio?
Nos dio?
La vida?
La vida?
Que bendiga?
Bendiga. Que bendiga.
Esta.
Esta.
Comida.
Comida.
Amén. Muy bien. Great job. Bien, bien, bien. Ok, salud ahora, ¿verdad? Now we can toast, ¿no?
Mm-hmm.
Salud. Salud a todos. Mm. Salud.
Salud. Bien.
Ok.
Oye, Nina. Like ostions.
Whoa, that was good, Dad. Wow. Muy bien, Leo.
That was good, Dad.
I love oysters.
One time I dove into this river in my ranch in Mexico. And
como extraño ese rancho, me.
And when I dove in, my legs were sticking out of the water and my whole head was stuck in mud. I found out the river was only 3 feet deep. Manny had to come to my rescue and pull me out by my legs. And when he pulled me out, an oyster shell cut my arm. 77 stitches. If I would have moved my arm inches to the right, this scar would have been right on my face. And beautiful Veronica wouldn't be here.
Why wouldn't I be here?
Because I wouldn't be as handsome.
Oh. Oh, man. Ay, mija. A este paso no pienso llegar nunca a ser el abuelo.
Anyway, so Manny fired you because you were late?
Eduardo.
And you? You walked out on him today? I mean...
¿Qué los que dicen?
And Manny despidió a la muchacha por llegar.
Oye, no empiece pelado.
Manny fired me too, before I even started working.
He never showed up for work.
You know what? Manny needs to learn how to cook anyway. He's too busy cracking the whip like El General, right? El General up on his fine horse. We should get a statue, right, and put it in front of the restaurant.
You should take Manny as an example. He's worked hard all his life. He started from zero, and look where he's now. Unlike you. Share this, but in the early years we couldn't have children. We tried. We tried hard. We did everything we could, but
Mom, don't mention such things in front of the children. I mean
And then when we were about to give up, one of his cousins back in Puerto Rico was a social worker. And before we knew it, we had adopted this beautiful baby. He was not even 3 years old. A really precious boy. I think the only difference between my three sons is the way that Manny came to us.
This is Francisco. Era el manager de José cuando él jugaba fútbol.
Soccer.
Soccer, sí. ¿Te gusta el soccer? Sí. Soccer.
I don't play soccer. You play soccer?
Sí, sí, pues seguro que sí. Todos los jueves y los sábados. Me llaman el viejo. Pero yo sí que puedo con todos los jóvenes. José, cuando debutó profesionalmente,
I'm sorry.
Después del accidente, nunca más volvió a jugar fútbol. No más soccer. Siéntate. No había visto a José como hoy en muchos años. Y eso te lo agradezco. El accidente le costó su pasión. Y sin pasión no se puede jugar fútbol.
Saying you can't play soccer without passion. This man has never wanted to learn English in his whole life. Have you?
I understand what he's saying.
He understands a lot more than we think, don't you?
¿Qué dices?
Que no te gusta hablar inglés, pero que lo entiendes bien.
Pues mi familia habla español. Si quieren hablar conmigo, que hablen español.
Well, it's getting late. I need to get back to the city.
No. You, Jose, stay here.
You see how he speaks English? Doesn't because he's lazy. But he's right. You should stay here and rest.
Thank you, but I really can't.
Es un placer. Esta es su casa.
Gracias. Take care. Hey. I need to go home.
Let's go to the beach first, and then we'll go from there.
Sure.
This is for you.
Just stay with me one more night. I know you're frightened by all that you've seen, but we'll leave the light on and listen to a song. You don't have to say a thing. Hallelujah.
I never saw anything like this before.
My father made it. I mean, they think he has too much time in his hands.
Oh, I just adored him. He is so great. Is he from Mexico?
No. My father is from Puerto Rico and my mother is from Mexico. So I am a Rico Mex. Means half Puerto Rican, half Mexican.
It's all the same to me. So is it always like that? Grow up with that
what?
Joy? Love?
That's nothing. I mean, when my whole family get together, muchacha, olvídate de todo. I mean, it's really crazy. The food, the music, the dancing, salsa, merengue. Wow. It's beautiful.
What does Manny feel about people knowing he's adopted?
To us, doesn't make a difference.
You are seriously lucky. You have a good family.
Yeah. What about your family?
My dad passed away when I was 12. No brothers or sisters. So that's my family.
Here.
Thank you.
What about your mom?
After he died, she just kind of sat on the couch with the remote, never moved on. I raised myself and her.
How was it dealing with your dad's death?
I don't know. I don't remember what the 12-year-old in me was feeling. I think that
My mom took it so hard that I didn't get the chance to grieve in a healthy way. It was like I had to take care of her, you know. At first, it brought us closer together, but I eventually turned into the typical teenager, and all that grief turned into resentment. One night, I got stoned out of my mind. I went home, walked in a room, and there she was, watching TV. I looked at her and started laughing at her, pointing right in her face. I told her how much I miss my dad, too. And I know that she's in pain, but I was in pain, too. And it was like for the first time she saw me again. I got the munchies. And we ate some donuts and talked about him all night. The next morning I woke up and felt like I had a mom again. But it was too late. When I was 18, my mom held out her hand. She waved her wedding ring at me. This tiny stone, my dad probably got at a pawn shop. She said, "You need to get you one of these." She loved him so much, she never took that ring off. That's what I want, Jose. I want to bring a child into this world out of love. With a man who's gonna take care of us. I don't have that. I can't have this baby and watch it suffer with me.
Voice told I love closer, drawn to these.
Here. I want you to keep it.
Oh. Thank you.
You're gonna come with me, right? Yo, don't worry about it. I'll be fine.
I'll call you. I'll call you, okay? Near a blessed Lord, to thy ever-pleasing
sound. Consecrate me, Lord, in thy service.
Steadfast hope, my will be lost in thine.
Let's talk about the salmon norteño, the special I want to come up with. The asparagus, mushroom, cactus. I'm going to throw in some avocado, some mango.
You're going to do what? You can always take a piece of the ocean with you.
How?
Well, when you take a seashell home, you put it right to your ears, and you can hear the ocean.
You want to try it?
Sure.
Okay. One, two, three. Here. Try.
Ah,
well, we're at the ocean. But when you leave the ocean, then you can hear it.
Hmm? I can hear it now.
You can hear it now?
Perfect.
Beautiful. Here she comes. Okay, let's go.
Last gift my father gave to me.
Thank you.
Would you meet me by the water, baby? We'll have a really good time. Would you meet me by the water, baby? 'Cause I can't get you off of my mind. Every day about you. Don't fit anywhere.
into my life.